Hola a todos, bienvenidos a mi canal. Me da mucho gusto que estén aquí sintonizando este video. Como pueden ver por el título de este video, pueden ver que vamos a estar hablando sobre el amor. Vamos a hablar sobre el significado, vamos a hablar sobre qué es el amor. Porque lo que yo hice fue que hice una encuesta y le pregunté a varias personas qué es el amor y qué es lo que significaba para ellos. Y digamos que había unas respuestas muy interesantes. Tuvimos respuestas muy diferentes, muy distintas unas de las otras. Yo me quedé sorprendida de que cómo la gente, o sea, todos tenemos una opinión diferente en qué es el amor. Y bueno, en este video yo quiero como descifrarlo y como ponerlo en algo más simple, qué es el amor. Y entonces vamos a entrar a este video. Hey everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am Daniela and I am so glad that you guys are here back watching my videos. As you guys can see by the title of this video, I am going to be speaking on the topic of love. Basically we're gonna kind of bring it all together and bring it to see what is love, what it means to people. So I did a little kind of survey thing. So I asked a bunch of people what love was to them and what did it mean to them. And let's just say I got a whole lot of different answers. And so basically today we're gonna analyze them and we're gonna kind of see what people think love is and what love actually is. So let's get into this video. So, entrando en el tema, me gustaría darles un versículo que a mí me llamó mucho, mucho la atención. Y es 1 Corintios 13, 4 al 7. El amor es paciente, es bondadoso, el amor no es envidioso, ni jactancioso, ni orgulloso, no se comporta con rudeza, ni es egoísta, ni se enoja fácilmente, no guarda rencor. El amor no se deleita en la maldad, sino que regocija con la verdad. Todo lo disculpa, todo lo cree, todo lo espera y todo lo soporta. Y ahora que hemos leído ese versículo, me gustaría explicarles un poquito de lo que hice con la encuesta. Si ustedes no sabían, yo había hecho una encuesta a ciertas personas. Les pregunté qué es el amor y qué es lo que significa para ellos. Para ser sincera, tuve, o sea, muchísimas respuestas a favor de esto. O sea, mucha gente, todos piensan de una manera diferente sobre esta pregunta. Por ejemplo, la primera persona me dijo que es algo incondicional y no hay como manera de juzgar a esa persona cuando tú lo amas, porque obviamente esa persona que ama a la otra persona siempre va a ver por encima de sus errores, o sea, nunca va a ver los errores porque los ama. La siguiente persona habló específicamente de la familia. Eso embarcaría como el tipo de amor hacia ciertas personas. Por ejemplo, en este caso, o sea, el amor a una familia va a ser mucho más diferente del amor a, digamos, una pareja o un matrimonio. Que eso nos llevaría a la próxima persona que nos dijo sobre que Dios es amor. Y ella básicamente embarcó eso, lo que Dios es el amor. Que sí, Dios es el amor, o sea, Él es el que creó el amor, es el amor, o sea, el que nos da para dar a los demás. La siguiente persona habló de los diferentes tipos de amor. Yo no necesariamente diría que son los tipos de amor, sino necesariamente serían las maneras de enseñar el amor. Que eso, o sea, yo quiero entender que esa persona quiso embarcar lo que es como las diferentes tipos de maneras de demostrar el amor hacia la persona. La siguiente persona habló sobre la autoestima y básicamente el amor que es para ti mismo antes de amar a otras personas, porque obviamente no puedes amar a una persona si no te amas a ti mismo. La siguiente persona habló de es que es una sensación personal, eso es algo que tú sientes personalmente. Y bueno, la siguiente persona habló sobre que es algo de buena voluntad, o sea, es algo que te nace hacer, o sea, algo que sale de tu corazón hacer hacia otra persona. La siguiente persona habló que sin amor no hay nada. Básicamente está como queriendo embarcar que sin el amor, o sea, todo está vacío. Es como sería la fe sin obras, o sea, si estamos hablando de la fe sin obras, si no haces nada para demostrar que hay fe, entonces en realidad hay fe, pero sería lo mismo con el amor. O sea, si no enseñas que en realidad tienes ese amor, que sería en el sacrificio, pues en realidad hay amor. La siguiente persona es querer el bienestar de los demás, o sea, siempre querer lo mejor para esa persona, sacrificar lo que sea con tal de que esa persona esté bien. La siguiente persona dijo que tiene que ser amor de los dos lados. Obviamente sí hay que ver amor de los dos lados porque tiene que haber un balance. Porque si no hay un balance, se va a desbalancear y luego el amor no va a ser concreto o no va a ser, como digamos, estable. La siguiente persona que Dios es el amor, es el que nos dio todo. Y sí, Dios nos dio todo, incluso el amor que sentimos por los demás, Él nos ha dado. La siguiente persona que se quiere uno demasiado, o sea, que una persona quiere o ama, sería la palabra, a otra persona. O sea, literalmente enseñan o demuestran esa compasión a la otra persona. La siguiente persona dijo que es un sentimiento súper, súper poderoso. Es algo que te hace feliz a ti, no más a ti, pero sino a la otra persona que tú estás demostrando ese amor hacia. Y la última persona nos dijo que es alguien que te atrae a ti. O sea, es alguien que en realidad, like, estás queriendo demostrarle esa atracción a ellos o ese amor a ellos. Y bueno, como ustedes pueden ver por esta encuesta, ¿cómo se dice? Respuestas súper, súper diferentes. Y es algo así, like, como interesante, porque como en una palabra, solo una palabra, hay tantas respuestas diferentes y tantas opiniones diferentes. Pero todo va a terminar en una sección, en una cosa nada más. Bueno, analizando el versículo que habíamos visto en el principio, que fue 1 Corintios 13:4-7, básicamente en ese versículo nos está diciendo lo que el verdadero amor es, nos explica qué el verdadero amor es. So, empezamos con el amor es paciente y es bondadoso. So, si somos pacientes y bondadosos, en realidad estamos teniendo ese amor. El amor no es envidioso, ni jactancioso, ni orgulloso. O sea, si no tenemos, está diciendo que no son esas cosas. So, si nos ponemos a analizar este versículo, podemos ver en realidad qué es el verdadero amor y qué no es el verdadero amor. Y así nosotros nos podemos dar cuenta que si en realidad estamos viviendo en un amor verdadero o si no. Entonces yo les voy a dejar con esta pregunta, o sea, ¿en realidad están viviendo un amor verdadero? Quisiera que ustedes se metieran a investigar este versículo igual. Ahorita se los voy a leer rapidito nomás para que lo vuelvan a escuchar. Pero este versículo les está diciendo que eso es el verdadero amor. So, entramos al 4. El amor es paciente, es bondadoso. El amor no es envidioso, ni jactancioso, ni orgulloso. No se comporta con rudeza. No es egoísta. No se enoja fácilmente. No guarda rencor. El amor no se deleita con la maldad, sino que regocija con la verdad. Todo lo disculpa, todo lo cree, todo lo espera y todo lo soporta. So, en conclusión, hemos llegado al final de este tema. Lo último que les quiero decir es que al final de todo lo miraría yo como un triángulo. So, en la punta de ese triángulo está el amor, que es equivalente a Dios. So, Dios es amor. So, Dios está a la punta de todo. Obviamente hay temas de diferentes tipos de amor, que fue lo que nos habíamos visto en la encuesta. Y obviamente todas esas respuestas están bien, porque son cosas que se deslizan de ese punto que es Dios. So, se desliza de lo que es el amor de Dios. So, en conclusión, Dios es amor. Pero les quiero dejar con la pregunta de que en realidad están viviendo un amor verdadero. Pero de todos modos, mírense ese versículo para que ustedes lo puedan autoanalizar y ponérselo a perspectiva de ustedes mismos. Así como yo lo hice, porque yo me he dado cuenta que en realidad no estoy viviendo un verdadero amor. O sea, siendo honesta, yo no estaba viviendo un verdadero amor. Porque yo no sabía en realidad qué era el amor. Que mucha gente también obviamente está súper confundida y no sabía cómo contestar la pregunta de qué es el amor. Bueno, me da mucho gusto que hayan visto este video, que lo hayan visto hasta el final. Espero que les hayan gustado y que les haya ayudado, les haya informado sobre qué es el amor. Y bueno, me da mucho gusto. Bye. Alrighty, so moving on into the English section. So we're gonna start off this kind of theme thing jazz. We're gonna start it with a Bible verse, which would be the 1 Corinthians 13:4-7, which says, "Love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast. It is not proud, it is not rude. It is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth." So, now that we have read that verse, I'm gonna move on into the little survey that I had done. So I basically asked a bunch of people what is love and what does it mean to them. And I can say that I had a few like answers, and they were pretty interesting because they were very different from each other, which kind of surprised me because I thought that people were gonna have one answer to it. But apparently a lot of people have a lot of different ways of thinking of what love is, and we're going to get into it right now. Alrighty, so moving on to into the survey and what people responded. The first person said that it is unconditional and it has no judgment. And yes, this is totally like good, because when you are in love with someone, you will look over their defaults, you will look over their mistakes, because you truly love them. When you truly love someone, you will not see what's wrong with them, because that's just how love works. And the next person said their love towards their family, which is another kind of type of love. So it's another, because love to your family is going to be so much more different to love towards a boyfriend, towards family, towards parents. It's always going to be different between those type of love, because the amount of love that's being put into it. And yeah, so that's just different types of love. The next person said God is love. So yes, God is love. He is the creator of love. He is the love. He is the one that gives us the love to give to others. The next person said that there is different types of love. So this also kind of goes on with what I just had said. So yeah, there is different types of love. I wouldn't say there's different types of love, but there's like different ways of showing your affection and showing your love, because there is only one type of love and there's really not another type of love. There's just different ways of demonstrating it to the person you truly love. The next person said love to yourself. Yes, loving yourself before you love others, that way you can actually love them. So that's what that person said, that you have to love yourself before you can love other people. Accept yourself before you can accept other people into your life, which makes so much sense. The next person said it's a personal sensation. It's something that comes out of your heart, something that you are able to give, something that just comes naturally from you. Because if you guys didn't already know, we were made to God's image and God is love. So in theory, we have to demonstrate love because it's in our nature. So the next person said that love is everything. And yes, love is everything, but they also said it's good will. So it comes from you to love. Like I had already said, it's from your nature. So another person said that it's that God had demonstrated it by sacrificing himself. And yes, he did sacrifice his own son in order to show his love towards us. Because if you show love without any actions, it's empty. There's nothing there. It's not being demonstrated. That way, we don't really know if you're truly loving. And that's what God tried to prove in here. Because he sent his only son to die on the cross in order to show the love that he had towards us. And by forgiving our sins. Moving on to the next person, they said that it has to be a two-sided love. So it has to come out of both ways, because that's the only way it's going to be balanced out. Because if you guys know how balance works, if it's not balanced out, it's one-sided, or the other way around. If it's one-sided, it's either going to not work, it's going to be dead, or it's just not going to, like I said, not going to work out. The next person said that it's God, and God gave us everything, gave us life, gave us, so yeah, so we should be totally thankful, because God is literally giving us everything and giving us the love that we now give to other people, sometimes without even knowing we give love, but it's still there. The next person says showing someone affection. So yeah, so showing affection to other people, like, it's another way of showing your love towards someone, showing them that you truly care. So the next person said it's a very powerful feeling, and it's something that you want someone to be happy, and you also want to be happy. So like I said, two-sided, both people are going to be happy. That's true love. The next person said they attract you. It's someone that you truly like, and you will demonstrate it to them. And something that you will see that they all have in common is that they say they want to demonstrate it, which is super important, is super big key into this. But let's go into analyzing the verse that I said in the beginning, so that way I can kind of like break it down for you guys. Alright, so if we move on into analyzing the verse, love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast. In the verse, it's literally telling us what love is, what true love is. It's telling us that it's patient, it's kind. So if we have all these things, you can be sure that you have love. So this brings us to our question. Are we truly loving? Are we truly having true love? And we can see it through this verse. It says it does not envy, it does not boast, it's not proud. So it literally tells you what things are embarked into love and what things aren't. And I personally can tell you, I looked at this verse and I was like, wow, okay, I can see where my mistakes are and I need to rectify them. So I would invite you guys to do the same as I did. Like, I realized I wasn't living in a true love or anything like that towards my family, towards anyone. So the verse is 1 Corinthians 13:4-7, if you guys want to check it out. I learned a lot from it. And basically, yeah, so true love is just God. So I would see it as there's like a triangle, right? So the triangle at the very top, because you see how all these people answered, so there was different answers. The thing is, all these answers are correct, and that's on period. They're all right. The thing is, God is at the very top of it, because God equal sign love. So if we bring it down into more things, obviously there's going to be more things under that, and that's where these things would come in. So literally, love is everything they said, but at the end of the day, love is equal to God. So I hope you guys like this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I know I sure did, because I learned a lot from him personally. I hope you guys did as well. So I please would like you guys, if you guys could check out that verse, the Bible verse, and just see and like analyze yourself and see where you are wrong or what you're already doing right, because it's also good to give yourself sometimes a pat in the back and be like, oh, I'm doing this correctly. So yeah, I think this is the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and hopefully it informed you in some way. So I appreciate you guys for tuning into this end of the video. Please subscribe and like, share it to other people, that way they can also learn. My point of this video is so people can understand and learn what true love really is. If you guys have any questions, you already know my social medias are open. So yeah, thank you so much for watching this video.